Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to get into the selection style. Now we're going to start focusing more on the music because I found that I'm getting a lot of questions about how to create transitions, how to create, you know, energy balances, energy movements in a song. It starts with the music. The music guides the mood of the song. When you start with the music, for example, a piano player can play a song with just one piano. They don't need an ensemble. They don't need drums. They don't need anything else. It's just the piano. So how is it that they can create these dynamic songs with just one instrument? Okay, so we need to focus more on the music, okay, because that will drive your song. Everything else is kind of like trying to add excitement to the song or variation to the song, but it all starts with the music, the song idea. So what we're going to do now is pull up a synth, actually. Let's do maybe Serum. Let's try Serum out. Because I want to create a really complex sound, and then we're going to build the chords. Usually I say build the chords and then build the sound. But in this case, I want to make a very specific type of sound, which is kind of modern and different. Now, there's tons of ways to create different sounds. I get that. But let's just focus on a super saw right now. Let's turn our unison up here to about 8, and let's change the detune pitch variation. So it's pretty close. Now the blend is dealing with volume, so volume of the background vocals in the green, and not vocals, background sound in the green, or the added voices in green, and the main voice in yellow. So I'm actually going to lower the background down in volume. Okay, now what I want to do is give the amp envelope decay time. So let's go to envelope 1, which is by default our amp envelope. Let's turn down sustain so we have what's called a decay sound. And I want it to be very short. But the thing is, I want to make it longer because I'm going to use the cutoff filter. I'm going to put an envelope on the cutoff filter to override this amp envelope. So I'm going to make it a little bit longer than I want it right now. Let's go to envelope 2. Do the same thing. Let's lower our sustain here. Let's drag envelope 2 over to the cutoff. Now we need to turn on our filter. This is by default a low pass filter at 12 dB per octave. Let's switch it to 24 dB per octave. So it's a very sharp curvature in the filter. Turn down the resonance for now. And we need to set the starting and stop points. So the stop point is going to be the far left side. Okay. Now I believe you can make this one-sided. If you hold shift, I could be wrong. This might not be the parameter to do that. Shift is actually fine-tuning it. Is it Alt, one of these buttons? So I'm thinking of the pitch, so forgive my reference there. But anyway, Shift lets you do micro movements. So it's a little bit different than Silence. Silence, you move the knob. Wherever the knob's pointing, that's the minimum value. In this case, the knob is not the minimum value. The minimum value here will be on the left. You can see that little blue dot kind of going from right to left. That's the movement we're using now. So envelope 2 is creating that movement. What we can do now is shorten the decay time from envelope 2 to make it shorter than envelope 1. What I'm going to do is extend it a little bit and extend envelope 1. I'm playing sloppily with my left hand on purpose. Now what I'm going to do is activate a little portamento, and I'm putting it on always mode so that it always pitch bends. And that will add a little glide between our chords. So let's audition it for a second. A little too much pitch bend. Let's turn that down. And also, let me open up the filter a little bit more. It's a little too dark. So what I want to do now is add a little more release time, because right now it sounds like a plasticky type of thing based on the cutoff filter. So let's add a little more release to the sound. And one more thing I'm going to pull up is resonance. We're going to hear more of that lasery sound. Now I'm going to add a sub oscillator to thicken up the sound a bit. Pull that level down. And let's detune it a little bit more. Pull up the blend just a bit more. When you use use a lot of voices in Serum, it eats up CPU. So you're going to see CPU spikes like crazy. It's one reason this plugin is too powerful for my system. But let's add another. Well, it's not too powerful, but you know what I mean. You're going to get clicks and things you don't want. I'm going to add one more oscillator here. Let's activate oscillator B and send that into the filter as well. And one thing you could do is pull this up an octave. Or you can do something pretty cool and pull your semitone value to +7. But I'm going to leave that option for when we complete our chord progression so we don't get too confused on what a chord progression is. Okay, so now let's get into the chords. Now this could be a lot cooler, I understand, with sound design. I'm not going to spend all day to create a cool sound. But let's send some white noise through the filter. A little more texture. And let's see what else we can do. Maybe extend the decay time of the filter. Okay, great. And there's plenty more things we could do with the pitch. Let's leave that for once we're done. Now let's get into the chord progression. Let's right click, tap out the tempo. You have to determine what kind of song you're making. I'm going to make a very swingy type of song. So let's right click and go to piano roll. Now I'm going to start with a fairly basic chord, just F major 7. But what we're going to do here is not just play it like all at once. We're going to spread it out using the strum tool. Now you can do this with your MIDI controller. I'm just going to use the MIDI function called strum. It's going to delay each note. Now I've noticed a lot of Solection chords are very cut short, so they don't have that long release time. They actually kind of finish after you're done playing the chord. So what I'm going to do now is just shape it a little bit more. Now envelope 2, I'm also going to give it a slight attack. And let's pull this up an octave. I think actually, you know what's creating that bass is the sub oscillator. Let's turn that down. And I think we can open up the filter a bit more. So that's why I say do the music first, then you can go back and fix the sound. A little too bright. Okay, anyway, without the small minutia, let's just build out our chords first. Let's use a metronome as a measure. So what I'm going to do now, actually I'm going to, let's do it this way. Let's do a glide note from D to E. Okay, so I'm getting rid of the note D. So it's going D to E. So basically, I'm trying to create the F major chord, but I'm using D as like an intermediate note there to create motion. And let's hold that out for as long as we can. Actually, I'm going to go barrel, 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 and then we're going to make it go fast. F A C E. Let's figure out where we want it to hit first. Let's go back. I want it right here, so let's do F-A-C-E, but this time I'm going to use the strum functionality, so it strums from the bottom note to the top note. It's a little too much strum, so let's control Z, give it less strum, it's just too wide, so let's turn that time in. Okay, so just small time variations between the notes. Okay, so now the question is, what other chords can we use? So I'm going to stick within the scale, which is all the white notes right now. I'm not going to create any borrowed chords or anything complex. But towards the end, we're going to start switching out chord types, and I'll show you how that creates a jazzier sound. Let's pull this down an octave. Oh, you know what it is? The white noise creating that. Let's turn that down. So now the question is, what's the next chord? Right now I'm trying to figure out the tone I'm listening to. I'm listening to these notes. So now the question is, what do I want to hear next? Let's try G. So in that case, we're going to make the A minor 7 chord. Now there's a thought process behind that. I'm just kind of leaving out the every step about it. You can learn more at busyworksbeats.com/music-theory. We're going to do the same technique. Do that slide note. Thank you. I'm going to get a little more melodic. Okay, so let's hit. Okay, so in my mind, I want another chord to hit here. So in that case, it's going to be the F major 7 chord because E is the top note of that chord. And again, I want those notes to slide, so let's... But I'm not going to use the strum tool. I'm actually going to do that same technique. Okay, so all I'm going to do now is copy these chords. And what I'm going to do is transform the major chord, the major 7 chord here, into a minor 7 chord. And I'm going to do the same thing over here. So it's going to play major, major, minor, major. Then it's going to go major, minor, minor. I might keep a major. I'm not sure what it's going to sound like at the end. So we need to convert this F major chord into a minor chord. And that's where chord codes come into play. So this is not even going to be an F chord. We're actually going to pull the chord down and pull it back up so that E is our top note. So we're not even in, it's not an F major chord anymore. It's F sharp minor 7. And you can see that twist adds that jazzy tone because we're not expecting to hear that. So when you start throwing in chords from different scales, that's where the magic comes into play. And we go over that in more depth at Chord Magic 2 at busyworksbeats.com/chordmagic. You can learn a lot more. Now we need to build out the sound. So now the question is, do I change this to a minor or a major? Let's see what that would sound like. So in this case, we would 0, 1, 2, 3. Let's pull that up to a 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. But we need to pull the whole chord down. Now I'm testing if this major chord sounds proper. If it doesn't, we're going to get rid of it. It does sound good, but the only note that doesn't sound good is that E. So now we just need to ask, does it sound good from here all the way through? It sounds good as is. So what I'll do is create variations. And this is the real power in chord progressions, is you can create variations from simple changes using the same chord structure. You don't have to, you know, rethink your chord progression. You just got to make small changes. And that's what our system is all about. Now let's make this a minor. Okay. So I'm skipping over everything about what I'm doing here because we explain it in more depth in our courses. But basically we're transforming the major into a minor. And then we're transposing the chord so that our, what we call pseudo leading tone, is still in the right place. Now this note sounds sour, or one of these notes, I think it's the E actually. Let's figure out the chord code. So it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 is right. Might be the D sharp here. Okay, it was the D sharp. So you hear those little artifacts. That's because of, you know, Serum demanding so much power. So this is an option. What I might do is get rid of that slide note so it's more direct. Okay. I think that fits better. So now let's work on the sound. You could spend almost all day on the sound. I'm not going to, you know, get too ridiculous with this. But what I'm going to do is make oscillator B and FM to A. If you don't understand what FM synthesis is, we have more videos at busyworksbeats.com. And we even have a free sound design course. It doesn't include FM synth, however, but at busyworksbeats.com/sound design. You can learn the fundamentals of sound design, learn the parameters, get to know what things do. So envelope 3, I'm going to use that atop the level of oscillator B. And I want to extend this the whole volume here. And what I'm going to do is FM B to A. So I'm going to click on the warp menu and go to FM from B and turn that up so that oscillator B will FM A for that short amount of time, envelope 3. And that's how you create that kind of metallic sound. What I'm going to do is switch out the waveform, however, into, let's try a regular sine wave. And I'm going to pull the unison down to 1. So let's extend the decay time. It's kind of hard to detect. Let's pull it up a couple octaves so you can really hear what's going on. And actually, we don't even have to have the level of oscillator B on. So let's actually reset that and remove the modulators and just turn it off. So it's still modulating A. It's just silent. And we need to give this FM amount an envelope. So that's what we need to do. We need to grab this envelope 3 and put it atop the FM so that it knows when to stop. Hear that small metallic kind of bite in the beginning, that's from that FM. You can hear that kind of different scrape sound. When you pull it into lower octaves, it adds more of a bubbly rumble, and if you pull it into higher octaves, it turns into a metallic scrape. So that's what I'm going to add, just to add more pluck energy, a transient energy to the sound. Now I'm going to open up the filter as well so you can actually hear it. That's the full sound. That's how they get those weird kind of, you're like, it sounds like an instrument, but I don't know what it is. That's what it is. Most likely FM synthesis. So let's go with a plus 4 octave. Just for that metallic transient. I'm gonna open up the filter. Let's turn down the FM amount so it's not as harsh. Turn down the amount. More sharpness in the sound, I would suggest lowering the envelope attack for the cutoff filter, because that was kind of blurring out the sound as well. Now, there are other things you can look into. Like, again, if you want more of that kind of stop and go sound, you might want to try sustain. But anyway, without getting too complex, let's just open up the hyper dimension tab. We're going to use the dimension tab for added kind of reverb environment. Basically, it's a reverb with a very short decay time. And I'm going to get rid of some of this release time, cut down on that kind of long tail sound. Okay, so now we have our vibe. Now we can switch out or transpose the key just using shift up or shift down, just moving the MIDI up or down notes. Just to hear the same chord progression in a different key. I like this vibe a little bit more. Okay, so now you saw how much work went into the initial sound. Let's add fruity delay. I like that immediate response with the long feedback tail. Again, you can add more texture to the sound. See what it sounds like without the sub oscillator. I think the sub is making it too blurry, so let's get rid of the sub. Now, I mentioned you can plus 7 the semitone here, but since we're using it as FM, it's not going to have the same effect. But that's an option if you're not doing FM synth. Let's drop this down an octave. Okay, so we found the better octave. So that's going to be the foundation of our song. So that just shows how much power music has in itself. We've created a rhythm. We've created a mood. Now we just need to wrap melody and different sound selection around that. So now let's go to busyworksbeats.com, find some nice drums that we can layer in. And you want to beatbox your idea. You can have your own ideas there, but let's go to X Drums. Actually, let's use the Ultimate Producer Bundle 2 here. Go to Fire Drum Kit. Load up some claps first. You want to look for very light sounds, especially spaced out sounds as far as time. Like this one has a, you know, it's like a long sound. It's not just like clap, clap. It's like, so those are the sounds you want to look for. Claps and snaps that go along with that long tailed, not long tail, but a long drawn out kind of a sample layer. Okay, let's go into the cymbals here. And we need to tune this, so let me normalize it so you can hear. It needs to be ding, so let's retune it. So I'm going by ear. But there is a more proper way to tune. We have that. Just type in tuning BusyWorks Beats, you'll find it. But I can go by ear on that one. Let's try our hi-hats. Click, 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 click. So let's do that. Boom, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and boom. And then repeat it. 1, 2. And I'm going to have it hit on that last snare spot. 1, 2, 3, 4. Boom, 2, 3, 4, and. So this hi-hat has a little delay in it, which is fine, but if that's too much delay, you can always chop that out when you edit your sample and just start with the transient. But I would suggest leaving a small time delay in your hi-hat. To do that, you want to go to your wrench tool and turn up time shift. But since there's already a program delay in the sample, I don't need to do that. Selection is all about the groove, and time differences create groove, so that's how you get that type of sound. Go to our kicks. Use kick hot in this case. And then we're gonna let's beatbox it first. So now let's realize that. So that's all we're doing. I think the hi-hat's a little too lag, so let me show you the process here. Let's right click, let's edit the hi-hat. We're just gonna change our snap to grid to snap to zero crossing so we can grab it at the zero phase positions. And I'm gonna get rid of this intro kind of tail. So delete that, and let's grab the whole sample once again, drag it into our sampler. So now we can control the time delay. It's not based on the sample. We're clipping now because everything wants to be loud, so let's turn this stuff down. I think the hi-hat actually sounds good where it is. It doesn't need any delay. Now, if you want to make it more complex, you want to add another layer of percussive movement. So let's try adding more percussion in here. You know, stuff like that. add the shaker. Now what I'm going to do is get rid of the reverb tail. But instead of using the out parameter, which you could do, I'm just going to go to the envelope for the volume. Let's turn down everything and turn down the decay. So it will only last for a specific amount of time. So boom, 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 boom. So let's add that over here. And we're going to add one more percussive element atop the shaker as well. Now I'm going to create one variation so our ear doesn't get too latched onto that pattern, and we change it up over time. So it goes boom, boom, boom. Okay, so the second one's going to go. That's how we're going to change it up. Now we need one more element to kind of contrast the shaker. So I want to go tick, 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 tick to tick, 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 tick to tick. So that's what I'm going to do. Let me sample out the first tambourine hit, get rid of the second hit, trim out any silence. Okay, so now we're going to add that tambourine. Go to pattern 8. Turn this up so you can hear it. Normalize the sound as well. So I want to go tick, 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 tick. So let's do that. 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 1. And then repeat it. All right, now I'm going to turn the... Actually, let's go to the mixer. Let's just turn it down with the fader. Right now, the tambourine seems a little early, so let's go to that wrench tool and turn up that time shift. So I'm gonna go tick, 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 to tick, tick. So now let's get onto the bass line. So the bass line, I'm going to keep it fairly simple as far as how to create a bass line. A lot of people are like, how do you get that thick bass? I've actually found that sine bass is very thick, just a simple sine wave and a little maybe pulse wave at that. So let's use 3X OSC, very simple oscillator. Let's just turn down oscillator 2 and 3, and let's lower our coarse pitch for the sine wave here. And I'm going to play really low notes, and it's going to create a nice subtone. Now here I'm going to use very steady notes, but I'm going to start the composition of the bass in higher octaves, because when you program in higher octaves, you can hear the tone, and then we can drop it down in the lower octaves into the sub range once we're done, and it will still maintain that same musicality. So I'm going to treat it almost like a melody. So a lot of people ask, how do you create bass lines? You know, melody magic will help you. You use a lot of melodic technique in bass lines. And if you don't understand melodic technique and how it applies to music theory, you can go to busyworksbeats.com/melody magic. I'll leave a link below so you can find out more. But a lot of technologies apply to the bass line from melody magic. Lot of slide notes here, but to do that I have to activate legato mode. So let's go to the wrench tool, turn on mono mode, which is essentially legato mode. So that's all we need. Now what I'm going to do is add a vibrato tail to the bass. It's a little more advanced, but let's go to the envelope tab. Let's go to pitch, let's go to envelope, or not, excuse me, not envelope, we're not going to use the envelope. Let's use the LFO window. And let's turn up the amount to a little bit. Now I'm going to exaggerate it so you can hear it. It's going at a very weird speed. Let's right click and set it to one step. So it goes. But let's turn the amount very low. And let's turn up the attack time. So it takes time for that to activate. So it adds a little more flair to our long-tailed sound. I'm going to increase the attack a little bit more so it's not as evident. So I'm using all the Melody Magic techniques here. I'm not really revealing them right now, but these are all Melody Magic techniques. So since the chord progression is almost the same all the way through, I'm going to copy and paste that until it sounds wrong. I don't want to spend too much time going through this idea because it can eat up time. So let's just hear it in context. And if we hear it's out of key or something's, remember, we made chord changes. So the key is going to change at a certain point. Right here, it sounds different because we have those chord changes, so we need to change the musicality of that section. To figure out which note needs to change. You know, at a certain point it sounds good, the tension, but somewhere it sounds kind of out of tune. So let's figure out where that is. So I think right here we can change that note. So let's change this. And I think that was a good option. So let's hit Control A and hit Control down twice to take this into the sub range. Now our ear can't really pick up every single pitch, but the reason we compose in a higher octave is so we can hear the pitch, or at least understand what we're doing MIDI wise. Now I think one of these rhythms needs to change. I think the shaker, because it doesn't fit some of the rhythms. I'm changing the boom, click, click, boom, click, 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 boom. I think that fits the groove a little bit more, a little better. Same with the tambourine. Actually, you know what it is? The hi-hat. Work on that tambourine. Sometimes simplicity works better. If you have too many rhythms going on, they can clash, and that's exactly what happened because our hi-hat pattern came before our bass pattern. And when the bass comes out, that's when you really start to, you know, realize the actual groove of the song. So now the bass line, remember, we're only doing half of the chord progression. So the question is, does that work for the whole chord progression? Let's see. It seems to work. kick activity, so let's go back to our kick. I think it adds a little more energy that fits the vibe here. Might want to consider using vocal chop samples as well to kind of add that human kind of vibe to it, like bo bo bo. But let's see if we can find one in Omnisphere. Let's pull up Omnisphere. Let's go to the human voices section, and we're going to go to the there's a specific patch here. We go to type, go to gender, female, and we're going to go to the soprano. Here we go. I think that just sounds great. Just that one note, the F note. And when you hold it, she changes her singing style, so she adds a different flair to it. So it's not just like holding. See, there's accent to it. Now here, I might want to split this in half so it goes F and then to a different note, because again, those chords dictate the musicality of everything else. So we have to kind of abide by the chords at that point. Step up to create that kind of energy change in the chord progression. So that added a whole new element, that human voice element. That's why I say vocals can really do a lot to a track. Now it's about adding sparkles, synth sparkles, and different synth things to the track just to accent it. Let's add one more synth. I'm not going to dig too deep into, at this point, it's about your creativity with synthesizing and the sounds you hear. But let's use portamento, mono, legato mode, low pass filter, and a lot of resonance. Brink, whatever that is. Okay. So we need to figure that out. So I want to go 1 to 1 to 1 to 1 to 1. So I'm going to go bum, ba bum, ba bum, ba bum, ba bum. So a lot of these slide notes. Let's drag that out for the next. Let's open up the filter so it's a little more heard. And I'm going to add that vibrato tail just like we did with the bass. Let's go to our LFO. Let's set it to pitch A. Give it a very small value, 0.1. Let's go to mod envelope 1. Let's tell it to control the LFO 1 gain. Let's turn that up just a little bit and give it a small attack. So over time, it will increase the LFO gain amount. Turn it on free mode and turn the rate on about 5 hertz. And over that attack time, it will create that vibrato effect. I'm going to give it decay so it doesn't go and then stop. I want it to go and then slow down. But if you don't have decay, it won't slow down. So let's. And we can make that sound better just by changing the waveforms. try a pulse wave instead, or a triangle wave. But with the triangle, it's very dull, so we need to crank up the volume. Also, I'm going to delay it so it's not so on the grid. So just small synth ideas. I mean, you can go on forever adding synths. Just like percussion at this point. Detune the sound a little bit more. You can do a lot more stereo wise with this. Like create a stereo delay. So what I'm going to do is use the imager for this, but you can also use Fruity Stereo Shaper. I'm going to create a delay between our left and our right ear. Let's turn on stereoization mode in Isotope. Let's pull out each band. I'm going to keep the bass mono, and I'm going to extend the stereoization amount. This is in milliseconds, and it basically controls the time difference between our left and our right ear. So it feels wider. Turn off the monitor so you can hear all the extra bass. Let's just hear it as it is. Now, one last step before we continue, I'm going to layer the chords with the piano just to give it that jazzy sound. So let's layer that so that it has a synth timbre and an acoustic timbre. So we have some live instrumentation in here. And also I'm going to add a bass note. So let's copy the chord progression. Let's go to a new pattern, paste it in. What I'm going to do here is zoom out, copy all the bass notes, every single chord or the bottom note of every single chord, the root note. And we are going to hit shift to duplicate and hit control down. That's going to create an octave lower. Let's hear the piano. This piano is still loading samples, so you might hear it cut off every now and then. And I might lower the octave. Let's hear it in the lower octave. That's too messy. Notice the velocity it's playing at as well. What I can do is raise the overall velocity by hitting Control A, double click on everything, and turn up the velocity meter. So it has a little more brightness to it. What I would do at this point is maybe modulate the cutoff knob. So what I'm going to do here is move the cutoff knob. I'm going to move it just a little bit. Go to the plugin options. Go to browse parameters. I'm going to right click, create an automation clip for the cutoff filter in Serum. So let's go back to the playlist. What I wanted to do is go lower when the piano comes in so that the piano has more attention than the Serum patch. So I'm lowering the general cutoff point for Serum. And that will lower the sound here. Let me see. These lines are getting crooked. Let's change it to bar mode instead. Right click, let's delete that point. Zoom back out. Let's extend our envelope. Let's right click. So make sure it's lining up. I'm just going to copy that low value, paste it in. So it's the same value all the way across. Copy and paste those points. Boom. Now the piano has more attention. Turn that bass down a bit. was. The cutoff filter was too low. You couldn't hear any notes, so I'm going to pull that up. The synth is just... I think it can be used earlier. It's just in a bad spot at that point. I was going to introduce swing on this, so I kind of deviated from my idea, but let's turn up the swing meter just a bit. I'm not going to get into everything about creating grooves. I'm just going to turn up the swing groove. And this affects the MIDI as well as the drum, so everything's affected by swing. Right and the cymbal left. Shaker as well. Tambourine to the right. Cut out the vocal section for the first half. So that's, you know, the selection style. It comes down to focusing on the musicality first, then adding the other elements. So if you want these project files, you want to go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. You can click that link below to get started today. And when you sign up with your email, be sure to confirm your email so you will get your free bonuses. And it's not only this project file, it's also other artist style project files and a free chord code book as well. I'll let you discover for yourself. Just click that link below or go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com.